Since the dawn of time, mankind has been yearning to make high quality recordings of zoomed in 3D prints. Okay, maybe that was just me. But I have been yearning a long time. And today, finally, this yearning is over. Camera equipment can be hellishly expensive. It's enough to make a grown man or woman cry. But it doesn't have to be that way. To build this, we're going to need some aluminium spacers, some 2020 aluminium profile. In my case, it's about 40 centimeters. We are also going to need an eccentric nut with a 5mm bore, a 1/4 inch UNC nut and bolt, some 2020 end caps, which I've obviously 3D printed, some M3x8 bolts and M3 nuts, a 3D printed 2020 profile tripod mount, a set of 3 V-slot wheels, any type you may have or prefer, a sturdy V-wheel runner, which you can also 3D print if you prefer, some M5 nylock nuts, and finally M5x25 bolts, preferably with a button head. One of the holes on your runner will be a slightly bigger hole. That is for the eccentric nut. It should be a relatively tight fit, so make sure to get it in there. The eccentric nut itself acts like a spacer, so we only need one bolt and one nylock nut to attach the wheel to the runner. To fasten the nylock nut, I recommend using a wrench to hold it, while you use your Allen key to fasten it from the other side. Be careful not to over-tighten everything. You still want the wheel to be spinning freely. And that's one done. Now just two more. The other two wheels will obviously be requiring a spacer, but apart from that, it's the exact same process. If you perhaps hear dogs barking in the background, you are not mistaken. That's Snippy entertaining the neighbor's dogs. Thank you, Snippy. There we go, two down. Be sure to check that all three wheels can move freely. If you are as unlucky as me, you might find that your runner won't fit onto your profile. But not to worry, you just have to adjust the eccentric nut. Just be patient and adjust that eccentric nut until the whole runner just suddenly slides on. There you go, nice and smooth. You want the runner to be able to move freely, but you don't want it to just slip off. A little bit of resistance is required. Clear the holes of debris to make it easier to insert the bolts. You might be asking, what are these bolts for? Well, they're for reinforcement. Ask me how I know. The bolts help prevent the top part from breaking off under weight and strain. Next, we will attach the 1/4 inch UNC bolt to our runner, and this will be used as a post to attach our camera equipment. This admittedly looks a little janky, but it does work. Here I am heating up a nut to ensure that I get a nice tight fit on that tripod mount. If you also do this, please be careful not to burn yourself. It gets really hot. To get the tripod mount fitted to the profile, it might be a bit of a tight squeeze. This is obviously intentional, but you can also see little pieces of plastic still coming off there. Oh. Nice. Okay, now put the runner back so that we can put the end caps in place. That'll prevent the runner from falling off accidentally, which will suck. Satisfying snap number one. Satisfying snap number two. You are going to need some kind of handle to move the runner backwards and forwards. And don't laugh at my approach, because this thing works pretty damn good. It's got a built-in little buffer. You don't necessarily have to attach your camera equipment at this point, but mine's pretty small, so I figured I would do it. And finally, onto the tripod. Damn, this is so smooth. One last action shot of my incredibly sophisticated handle, and then we can start making some videos. The benches you see here were all printed with Full-X SBS and with zero part cooling fan, so you will see a little bit of drooping on the overhangs. SBS is naturally translucent, so the glitter really shines in this benchy. Getting this close to my 3D prints really makes me appreciate the incredible accuracy with which our 3D printers are capable of printing nowadays. You do need a steady hand to use this cheap slider, but I'm starting to get the hang of it. The layer height on this benchy is the standard 0.2 millimeters, and at the bottom we can see the line width of 0.4 millimeters. At this level, even dust particles appear massive, and you can even make out the tiny imperfections in the filament itself. All things considered, this cheap little slider has blown me away. In time, I hope to learn to use it properly and produce more shots like this for my own amusement and hopefully yours. If you have watched this far, wow, thank you very much. And if you are from South Africa, please consider supporting Next Dimension Electronics. I got all my hardware from them. They are very reasonably priced, and you can even buy some Full-X, SBS and PETG from them. They can deliver countrywide for you, and they are super friendly. All the links you require will be in the video description.